In this particular array problem, I am going to show you how you can find the smallest and the largest of a given set of numbers from an array. Let us say I have the numbers 10, 20, 30, all the way till 80 and so on. For me, the numbers I can see, the largest is 80 and the smallest is 10. Let us say I define a preprocessor symbolic constant called as max 50. What this indicates is that 50 is going to be the maximum number of numbers I can store or read into my array. I have defined an array of integers a of max. Max is going to be substituted with 50. N is going to tell me how many numbers the user is actually going to enter. Although the capacity is 50, the user may say, no, yeah, I'm just interested to enter only 5 or 10 numbers. So I'm going to read the numbers. Read array, we have done it in a number of programs before. X contains the address of the array. I am going to read the elements of the array using a for loop. So if I say 10 numbers, 10 numbers are going to be read at that particular memory address, which is going to go back into main. Now, once I read the data into the memory addresses, I am using a function called as large underscore small underscore array, where I am passing the name of the array and maximum number of elements the user has entered into the array. So read array, the prototype was, it is address of the array is being passed, that's why it is int star. Here it is just a normal value is being passed, that's why it is int. Similarly, in large small array, the address of the array is being passed, that's why it is x. Here the size of the array is being passed, so it's a normal integer variable. Now what I can do here is I can go ahead and try to type the code for this particular function. So let me minimize this fellow. I can go ahead and minimize this chap also. Alright. So now let me type in the code for trying to find the largest and smallest. So what I can do here is I'm going to define a variable int I is equal to 0. Okay. And I'm going to say declare an integer variable large. I'm initially assuming large to be x of 0, or the 0th element to be the large. Then I am saying the small also is the same one. Okay, sorry. The small is also x of large. Sorry, x of 0. This you will understand once we get into the loop. Then in the loop, what I am doing here is I am starting from I equal to 0, I less than n. I am going to keep continuing to search till the end of the array. Not search, I'm going to continue to compare large and small with the current value of x of I. So what I'm doing is I'm not going to start with 0, I'm going to start with the first location, because already I have assumed my largest and smallest to be the 0th location. So no point in comparing 0th location with 0. So if x of I, okay, if x of I is greater than large, all right, my new large is going to be x of I, alright. So this is how I change my value of large. Same with small. If x of I happens to be lesser than small, okay, my new value of small is going to be the current value of x of I. We're going to say small is x of I. Alright. Let's say small is x of I, and here I am going to complete my for loop. Alright, and at the end of it, I am going to say printf largest is percentage d, smallest is percentage d slash n, and then I'm going to close. I'm going to say large, and I'm going to say small. Alright. So just bear with me, I'm going to go ahead and explain to you once we enter certain numbers. Okay, so this is the code for my large small. So what I have done is I have assumed my largest to be the 0th location, and the smallest also to be x of 0. Starting from the first location, what I'm doing is I'm comparing every number with large. If that new number is bigger than large, then my large value is replaced with x of I. Similarly, if that x of I is lesser than my small becomes the new value of x of I. This particular process keeps on repeating till I has become equal to n. That means we have completed looking into every possible element of the array. At that point, I'm simply going to say large is percentage d, small is smallest is percentage d. Print the values of small and large. Now, what we can do is we can just take this code, copy it into the online GDB compiler, try to run it and see if things look fine. All right, let's first try to copy it. Let's try to compile it because we're not sure once we compile things are right. Okay, we're lucky. Number of elements into an array. To keep the explanation simple, I'm going to enter only 5 numbers into the array. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to enter minus 1, minus 2, 0, 1, 2, and okay, that's it. I think these are 5 elements. So what should be my largest? My largest should be 2. What should be my smallest? My smallest should be minus 2. Alright, let's see if that's the case. Okay, largest is 2, smallest is minus 2, which is what exactly we got. So how this particular fellow ended up working? If you take a look at it, I entered number of numbers as 5. Then the user entered these 5 numbers. Okay, initially large as well as small was minus 1. Then I kept comparing the large and small with every value. If this particular number 2, 0 or 1 was bigger than large, then this number replaced large. If it was smaller than small, this number replaced small. So this way I was able to print the largest and smallest number into an array. So hopefully this should have given you an idea how we find the largest and smallest. I would suggest you go through this by taking the sample data shown above. Run through the sample data and see whether you're getting the same results as what this particular piece of code should get.